What is it you're after then?
Oh man, we're taking a 67-foot yacht down to, it's going to Rio, but I'm only going as far as Durban in South Africa with it. I'm coming back there to take another boat on another trip. So it's going to be quite hot down there, and I thought I'd get the hair taken off with this one.
Where are you going down there? You have to get money from England.
Yeah, we fly from England to Seattle on the 11th of June. And we head out around by Alaska up to the Bering Straits and then across the top of Canada. And Greenland, Iceland, and we want to finish in Scotland. So, did you see the, what's it called, the deadliest catch? The crab fisherman?
Yeah, Dutch Harbour.
We'll be stopping at Dutch Harbour on the way around. So it's going to be...
Oh, that's a television thing.
Yeah.
Yeah, I see them. Yeah.
These crab boats. We're pulling into their home base.
Yeah. Interesting.
Yeah. So it'll be interesting. It'll be cold. Hopefully we don't get frozen in and have to walk out, which happens from time to time.
Is that right?
Yeah. An Irish crew did it there. And I think they went, had to go back twice. They had to walk off the ice twice to, you know, as the winter encroaches.
This boat
you're on would have been luxury. It's quite nice, yeah. I had a look at it there on the web. This guy had the boat built with this in mind.
Yes.
I think 2007. And he got prostate cancer. And like he had the boat ready to go, he had all the food, medical supplies and all.
Yes.
So we sent people back out to strip the boat off and he put it up for sale. And he beat the cancer then. And the boat never sold, so we decided that he was going to go again on this.
Yes.
So, like, I only talked to him on Monday and he says, come over on Wednesday and we'll have a chat. He seems like a good guy, knows his stuff.
Yes. You'd be very experienced now, Derek.
Yeah, that's kind of why he picked me, you know.
You can do anything.
Well, I wouldn't say anything.
You try anyway.
I'd give everything a match on.
You'd be gone a while then, Derek?
This first one, I'll be away for about 6 or 7 weeks. And then the next one, let's say from early June, and we'll be back in early October. We'll hopefully sneak another one in before Christmas.
That's great.
Remember the first one you got?
Yeah.
That was good. You've never been on, done one before, have you?
That was the clipper boats.
Yeah.
Yeah, we took off and did around the world, that was.
And you've never been done one before?
No.
that was great experience.
Oh, it was brilliant.
Is that an Irishman you got?
That's an English crowd. Yeah. They run this race every second year.
Yeah.
And I said the 0506 when I did it. Well, the best part about that was I walked me back off for 18 months solid to pay for that.
That's right.
Remember?
Yeah.
Every penny I had was going into that boat.
You're doing the tunnel then?
That's right, yeah.
Very good, the port tunnel,
didn't you? Well, I worked on a jet for 4 years. You know, I walked by the gate of the site where the tunnel was just starting.
Yes.
And I turned back and I said, I'll see if there's any work in here. You know?
Yeah.
And your man said, yeah, he said, start with me next week. And that was it. 4 years and 2 weeks later.
I never had to start working. And the working was good then. But no, it was easy up then, wasn't it?
No, it was good then. Yeah, it was good. It was 2008 when everything really started slow, and then December 2008 that put a finish to us.
Of course, you
were
doing the gardening then,
weren't you? I was doing bits and pieces, the odd job here and there to get an extra few quid.
Yeah.
And then one garden I did, I got €1,500 for it. And that paid for one operation on the boat.
Ah, jeez.
And I had two more after that.
Was that, that wasn't an accident, too, was it?
No, it was just years of hard work playing and, you know, bad falls and, you know, I fell off a couple of cliffs and bad landing out of a parachute. That kind of stood with me for a while.
Just your normal accidents.
Your best one of all is when did you have a kayak?
Yeah, yeah.
And maybe you go from Dublin, you went down to Kenny, was it?
Down to Bunclody, down the river.
From Wexford,
yeah. Yeah, and then I put in a Balkan glass, so it was kind of any further up the mountains, you wouldn't have got this kayak in, it was too big, you know.
Yes.
So that was a great trip, but mm-hmm. Like I've done, I think, most of the coastline as well between here and Wexford. Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, that's great, just to get out on the water and
yeah, that's your favorite thing.
That's peaceful. And
that's what gets you the job.
Yeah, just
tell them
much
you like it. That's
amazing. Yeah. Well, I told that guy, like, I've got the heavy scuba driver instructor set.
Oh, yeah.
I did a few years ago as well.
That helps.
And I could repair that because he's a dive master.
Yeah.
So he's like, oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. And it's a good thing, like, you must have a bit of fun on this trip, you know, so it's not going to be awfully serious,
yeah.
Which I was delighted to hear, you know.
Why did you get it just for a trip?
Yeah, just a personal achievement, and
yeah.
Only about 10 months every year do this trip, you know, because it's only open for a couple of months before it ices down for the winter. And a friend of his actually climbed Everest. And there's so many, he said, like, this guy had to queue up to walk the last bit up onto the very peak of the mountain.
Is that right?
Yeah, just
so many doing that?
Yeah, if you have money, anybody can buy it, you know.
Yeah.
And then it's just a matter of sitting out and waiting for the weather, and the Sherpas will get you up, right?
Yeah.
And he wanted to do something special, but not that, you know. And he heard about this Northwest Passage from a guy he was talking to. And he says, like, that's going to be the special.
What's he work as, Dave?
He's got seven companies. One of them is a property. And he's got a couple in engineering. He makes these kind of mobile car parks. If, just say a hotel has a huge car park and they have an event and they don't have any spaces, this guy will come in and put another level of car park all made out of steel, straight over. Yeah, actually made out of steel, yeah. He makes porta cabins for building sites for guys to live in. Each cabin, they're only small, two beds and a shower in them. And other bits and pieces to do with that. Like, they're all done very well, you know. And he lives in a beautiful house up the mountains there outside of Manchester. Seems like the down well around the chaps level.
Yeah. Yeah.
And will be many on the boat?
There'll be five. The maximum number will be five. And I think one or two people will be leaving and joining in various places.
Mm-hmm.
How do they plan to get out? To these, because I could be right up across, we're at the top of the wilderness, we're in the Arctic Circle, and then, like, people are like, some people will be leaving and joining the boat, you know. And this will be, from what I'm used to on boats, I'm used to going out and on boats and racing boats, like, this will be comfortable.
Do you know any of the rest of them that are going on the trip?
I don't, no. On Wednesday there we were driving out to Wales up towards Bangor to meet another crew member. But Did you hear about that ship that went up on the rocks?
From
the quarry?
Yes.
That slipway is right beside the road, and all the emergency services had the motorway closed off. So we couldn't get through to meet this other crew member. But I'm sure they'll be fine enough if anybody wants to do the likes of this.
Mm-hmm.
You know, kind of puts us all on the one wavelength, if you know what I mean.
Mm-hmm.
Or a bit more smoothly, but...
be a fantastic trip.
I tell you, it'd be beautiful. I went down, we didn't stop in Seattle, but we sailed past it, up into Victoria there before Vancouver. And you've got the mountains, the Rockies coming down right to the coast on either side of the Sound. So we'll be heading up there again and then tucking in behind Vancouver Island, quite close to the coast. Liam, I'm going to bring, you know, I don't know how many SIM cards with me for the camera. I'll be taking a million photographs.
Will you be able to upload them onto Facebook and all that?
Maybe when we get into port.
Mm-hmm.
I'm not very good at computers and this stuff, really. But I'll get some up.
You'll have to keep in touch. Put them up onto our page, our Waldorf page.
Oh, you've got a page,
yeah?
Yeah. Oh, okay.
Brilliant.
Yeah. So I've started keeping diaries from these trips.
Oh, very good.
Yeah, and photographs, and I'm saying one day I'll sit down and put a book of photographs together.
It's great.
Oh, I think it might be. Because there's really, for what I was doing here, there's nothing left of it, you know. And if I was to go away and work in Canada or England, their working system is much different than here. So you're going over there to do transfer courses and, you know, it costs a lot of money.
You never done the flying, did you?
I took a few flying lessons for years ago.
Yeah.
When I was working in Texaco.
Yeah.
And, no, sorry, it was before Texaco. I was working for a guy out an adult, PJ Roach. Air truck.
Okay.
It's a trucking company, yeah, a harness company. A gas man, but when I only started with them, they had me up and down this country, like, all hours of the night, morning. You know, sometimes only a few hours sleep. Things be gone again. So I was missing classes and then, you know, obviously quite important. I don't know, it's good to be able to say that. I landed and took a plane off, like, you know.
You landed?
Yeah, I was able to take off. I had a 10-hour spine or something like that.
My name is
Ryan, I only heard of him on the radio though this morning. It's a big cattle sale down with his family.
Oh, yeah.
When are you heading off on your trip?
Tomorrow.
Oh, genie.
Yeah, in the airport. The flight is at 7:30 in the morning. And fly as far as London.
Yeah.
We land in the city in Oman, I'm not sure the name of it. And then we catch another flight, it's about an hour and a half, to a port called Shalalaha.
Mm-hmm.
And we'll be there for approximately 10 days because the skipper's not coming out till the 18th. So I'm going out and I've got to buy fuel for the boat, buy all the provisions. And he wants me to buy two rifles as well, two Kalashnikovs. Because we cut straight out across Somalia, the coast of Somalia there. Yeah. So, I told the last time we were up this neck of the woods that I didn't want weapons on board.
Yeah.
Like, your chances of getting shot with it when you have a weapon on board increases greatly. So I thought, look, we won't have them. Well, on this leg of the trip now, he's insisting, so there's a guy, an agent I've got to get in contact with, and I think he's going to supply us with two Kalashnikovs. And it'd be more really for a show of force than anything else.
Yeah,
well, I can shoot already, mean.
Yeah.
So, the other guys in the world would be worried about, I've never handled a weapon.
Yeah. That's the danger, isn't it?
Yeah.
Have you been
drinking
on board?
No. No, like we'll have a good drink before we leave and when we get in, but we never carry drink on with us. But yeah, it could get too messy if I think it is. But I tell you, we are known to have a good drink when we get in.
We wish you all the best anyway.
Cheers, thanks very much.
And we'll see you when you're home.
Oh, look at Ken. Jesus, the grey and all is coming through now, look.
That's some heavy hair.